Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning, very good morning. Just for 2 minutes, I request you to be on video. Later on, it's your wish because I'll also be switching off my video. Just to know each other, that's the only thing. Pritam, have you started recording?
Sir, it is not showing in your system.
Okay, right. Yeah, Dhruv, Hari, Pratham, Surekha, sorry, Yash and Archita, are you comfortable in coming on video? Just for 1 or 2 minutes, later on we can go back to, yeah. Okay, thank you Dhruv, thank you Hari, thank you Pratham, and Yash and Archita, and hopefully Rahul also has joined, I think. So hopefully you are enjoying this sessions. I have organized my things and we'll be beginning the sessions. The topic I was given for today's discussion was technology trends and cutting edge technologies. So this was a topic given to me. And what I have decided is I'll try to touch bases with a few of the cutting edge technologies which are called as the fourth generation technologies, which are like blockchain or cyber security or artificial intelligence or RPA, robotic process automation, or many more in these lines. So machine learning, you can take machine learning algorithms. So what else I can say? Analytics, business analytics, data sciences. These are the cutting edge technologies which I'll be trying to touch bases with. I'll be starting first with blockchain in business. First of all, please tell me, is the screen visible to you? Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Great, great. So this is the topic in the morning session we'll try to cover. Blockchain in business, and as you can see the word here, disruptive. Okay, as you can see the word here, disruptive. You just pause for a few seconds, try to think of what disruptive may mean, and let us try to understand that word also. Okay, so again, the next session I'll be taking under the heading emerging and disruptive technologies. So again here, the word disruptive is there. So you just think for a few seconds what it might be.
Yeah, okay. Your name is also there, same.
Okay, give me a few seconds and you also pause for a few seconds for just connecting with this disruptive technology world. Somebody help me out with the disruption word. Don't remember that. Can you tell about disruptive disruption?
It's something that can create like a big impact within the sector.
Great. Archita, can you help? Rahul, can you help for the word disruptive or disruption?
Something which is not continuous.
Okay, but when we speak about disruptive technologies, it is going to make 360 degrees change in the way things were happening, the way routine works were happening, the way things were happening, the way processes were being done. So that's what is disruption. So when they speak about disruptive technologies, they always speak about the technologies such as artificial intelligence, machine learning, then robotics, then blockchain, then cybersecurity. So all these technologies come under that. So among this, we are taking the first technology, that is blockchain in business. Again, same question. Let us try to be let us try to all of us be in a comfort zone and try to be freely exchange our ideas. If we know it, if we know it, if we don't know it, we don't know it. No stress, nothing. So some of you definitely might have heard the word blockchain. So you can just, if you know it, fastly tell, or else, if you know it, fastly tell, or else we can proceed further. Anybody knows what is blockchain?
Sir, is it related to cryptocurrency in some way?
Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. This is who? Is this Yash or what?
This is Dhruv.
Who is talking? Okay, great, great. Dhruv, great, you are right. As Dhruv rightly pointed out, blockchain is related to something called as currency, that is cryptocurrency, or you can call it as electronic cash. So you have currency, cryptocurrency, electronic cash. So blockchain is such a technology which makes this electronic cash transactions possible, which makes cryptocurrencies possible, which makes cryptocurrencies possible. Sir, mere ko jagah batao, main jaate jata hu udhar. Okay, sorry, there was a small disturbance. So, and in today's session, what are the takeaways? We'll be learning what is blockchain technology, why blockchain technology is important, growth and business opportunities, where blockchain technology is used, use cases of blockchain in telecom, hospitality, travel, sports, luxury. So hopefully this will also enable students to make informed decisions in their career options and future studies, or to embed blockchain technology as a case study, as a use case, as a project in their learning curve. Again, questions, and have a look at this. Spend few seconds on this image which is there on the slide, and then we'll try to proceed further. Okay, if you observed it, now somebody has to tell me about this. Now, Dhruv, I'm excluding Dhruv from the discussion. Others, please try to respond. I'm highlighting this point. Tell us about this.
Bitcoin.
Excellent. This is Bitcoin, as the symbol B is there. So this symbol B, which is for Bitcoin, this has to be done. So next, after this Bitcoin, somebody please tell about this person.
Did you recognize the person? Nakamoto.
Fantastic. And who is telling me this? Who's the boy?
Me. Hari.
Hari, great. Hari. So that's, yes, perfectly correct. And as you already told the name, tell us more about him. Tell us more about Satoshi.
He's technically the founder of Bitcoin, but he is anonymous. We don't know whether he is actually the founder of Bitcoin or not.
Excellent. So as Hari told us, he is Mr. Satoshi Nakamoto. he is Mr. Satoshi Nakamoto. He is known to be as the inventor of Bitcoin. He is known to be as an inventor of Bitcoin. Okay. And what is a Bitcoin? It's a cryptocurrency. It is for electronic cash transactions. It is for electronic cash transactions, cryptocurrency. And his name is Satoshi Nakamoto. We'll come back to him again. So other than Hari and Dhru, somebody tell us about what this image may be. What this image may be. Archita, would you like to tell? You can guess, but talk. So
yes, sir.
Not Dhru, not Hari.
Sir, I mean, I know Bitcoin purchase.
There is a disturbance, I think, at your end. Can you repeat whatever you said? Yeah. Hello. I didn't get what Archita said. But as
Hello.
You... No, Archita, there is a disturbance.
It is a Bitcoin purchase receipt.
Okay, who said that?
Rahul, sir.
Rahul, great, Rahul. You are right. Archita, sorry, I could not listen to you. Maybe there is a disturbance. I don't know at my end or your end, but I could not hear you properly. You are correct, Rahul. This is a Bitcoin transaction. And there is a written here also that Bitcoin purchase has been done. So that is a, it is like a receipt, or it is like a proof, or it is like a bond, or it is like an agreement kind of thing. So now coming back to this person, Rahul, can you repeat the name of this person?
Satoshi.
Yeah, correct. Satoshi Nakamoto. Satoshi Nakamoto. Now let us come back to this person. This person, we don't know whether he is there or not. This person, we don't know whether he is there or not. Whether this is a physically alive person or whether this is a fictitious entity. Okay. So there is a chance that this person may not be there at all. And his identity is created. His identity is created because we know that the entire Bitcoin journey is more of Satoshi Nakamoto name can be connected to Bitcoin, can be connected to further journey of cryptocurrencies and blockchain and so on. So presently, whether this is Satoshi Nakamoto or whether this is a fictitious representation, but this gentleman, to this gentleman goes the credit of inventing or creating Bitcoins, inventing or creating the Bitcoins. Okay. So as you can see here, this is the Bitcoin Genesis block. This is the Bitcoin Genesis block. Means what? This is the first Bitcoin created. This is the first Bitcoin created. And as you can see, it is encrypted. It is encrypted. Encrypted means it is hidden. It is hidden means secretive. So whatever information is there, whatever information is there, it is in an encrypted format so that nobody should be able to open it and misuse it or take away it, whatever. Or he should not understand that, all that aspects. So that is what is the Bitcoin Genesis block. We know that encryption is for security. We know that there are many encryption algorithms, symmetric key algorithms, asymmetric key algorithms. So in Bitcoins, the algorithm which is very, very famous, which is used, is SHA algorithm. It may be SHA-2, SHA-256. So it may be normal SHA. But SHA algorithm is a famous algorithm for use for encrypting the Bitcoin blocks, encrypting the Bitcoin blocks. So what is the long form of SHA? SHA stands for Secure Hash Algorithm. SHA stands for Secure Hash Algorithm. That is what is the meaning of Bitcoin. That is what is the meaning of Bitcoin. Or this is the, now what is the significance of this Bitcoin Genesis block? The significance of this Bitcoin Genesis block is that this was never sold. This was never sold. This has a legacy value. So maybe let us say its actual value is $1. But as it is legacy coin, as it is legacy coin, so it has a huge value. It has a huge value. For example, there may be a 1 rupee coin, but that 1 rupee coin may be 1,000 years back. So that 1,000 year 1 rupee coin, if Rahul gets it, or if Arjita gets it, or if Dhruv gets it, they may sell it for millions or billions of dollars. Is it not? So they have a legacy value. They have a, like that. As they are old, they have got that value. Now, we have spoken about Satoshi Nakamoto, this Bitcoin, and this Bitcoin purchase. So this journey initially was not on a legal trail. The initial journey was not on a legal trail, as in everything was secretive, everything was not going through the legal corridors, legal system rules and all that. The blockchain, which evolved as Bitcoin came, blockchain is following the path of legal trail. Blockchain has got acceptance and so on. So let us try to understand this blockchain. So simply, for creating a Bitcoin, you need to have blockchain. For creating a Bitcoin, you need to have a blockchain. And by the way, I just want to confirm, am I audible?
Yes.
Great, great. So I also have a request. So if something goes wrong, what happens is I may be continuously talking, but my connection may lose. So what I'll be doing is I'll be just sharing my number, phone number in the chat window. You can just give a missed call or ping me so that I can come back and continue the session. Will you do it? So I put my number in the chat window. I put my number in the chat window, or you can tell Pritham also, and Pritham's number also I'll put in the chat window. So we are speaking about blockchain. So we'll try to go one point at a time. What is
the one doubt, sir?
Yeah, yeah.
So what was the first purpose, actual purpose behind this creating of Bitcoin?
Yeah, fantastic question. But who asked this question?
Rahul, sir.
Rahul, great Rahul. So I'll ask you a counter question. All of you play a lot of games nowadays, computer games, video games. You use Nintendo and you use that Sony PlayStation. Why you play that?
Xbox.
Xbox. Fun. But why you do that?
Fun, enjoyment.
Yeah. Great, Pratham, great. Now, I have a next question. Slowly, you understand the nitty-gritties of computer security, hardware, how to track, how the internet works. Then slowly, hacking creates a lot of interest in many of us. So there is a chance that in these six people also, there may be hackers, but good hackers also. I'm not saying hacking is bad. So why you hack, Rahul, again? Hacking, you know, all of you know hacking, right?
Yeah.
Great. Rahul, my counter question to you is, why hacking has come?
Some might feel thrill in hacking.
Good, good. Any other answers? Dhruv, you can also participate. Hari, you can also participate.
Ethically, to strengthen security systems.
Okay, excellent. So as we know that hacking, as Rahul told or Dhruv added on that, so it's a fun part comes first, thrill part comes first, then you become more serious. Then sometimes you feel system is not right. I have to set the system. For example, this is just an example. Don't take it very seriously. For example, let us say you're angry with someone. So it may happen that you may have his system. There are chances, right? Somebody is angry with Dhruv, and one day Dhruv finds that his system is hacked. And so Rahul, I am trying to connect the dots. What was your question? Why Bitcoin?
Why Bitcoin scams?
So now my again explanation here is why Dhruv's system was hacked by his
first
friend.
Purpose, yes.
Friend, he was angry with him. Then it may happen that Hari is there in your class. He is very patriotic. He likes India very much. He doesn't like enemies of India. So someday what Hari may decide, Hari feels that I belong to India and the enemies of India are, let us say, nobody's enemy. Don't take it very seriously, but I'm just giving you a general example. So Pakistan is India's enemy. China is India's enemy. XYZ countries is India's enemy. Let us hack their governments. Websites. Let us enter into their portals. What Hari did? Rahul, tell me what Hari did. Again, hack the system. Why he did? So the answer to your question, right, is related to same thing here. I'll come back to that. But here, in this hacking example, one was doing for fun. One was doing because he did not like Dhruv. He had an argument with Dhruv. One was a patriotic. He was a good man. Hari is a good man. He loves his country. But in for patriotism, for sure, he has done that. So there are multiple reasons. Similarly, there is a system in the world. Which system? Legal system. In this legal system, there are police, there are laws, there are ministers, there are courts, then there are lawyers, there are judges, then there is currency. Okay, is it not? For in India, use rupees. We have 100 rupees note, we have 1000 rupees note, we have 500 rupees note. We go to a McDonald's and we buy a burger. We go to some pizza shop and we buy a pizza and we pay money in cash. We may pay 100 rupees, we may pay 500 rupees, we may pay 1000 rupees. So, this is money. Money transaction through cash. So, Rahul, you tell me, from where you get your money? Excellent.
Bank.
Excellent. So you'll be getting everything through the bank. I have a question to all. I have a question to Pratham. Pratham, do you have a bank account? Great.
Yes, sir.
So do you use your ATM card? Do you use your debit card? Do you withdraw the money from the ATM? Do you do some, you go to say some mall and you buy something and you use your card?
Technically, no, sir.
If you don't use, your father might be using, your mother might be using, your elders might be using.
Yes, sir.
So you know that for keeping the money in the bank, some tax may be cut, right? For doing transaction in ATM, so you may have to pay some money for keeping the money in the bank. Also, you may have to pay some interest. You may have to pay some amount. Are you getting it? What I'm saying. So, it is you and your money, but there is a third person involved. What is the third person? The banking system and the legal system. There is a third party, the banking system and the legal system. Okay. So, you are paying the money. I'll take one more example. I'll ask Hari now. Hari, do you have a bike or a four-wheeler?
No.
Okay. Who has a bike or a four-wheeler in this class? Great, Pratham. But let us take this hypothetically. Yes, am I audible to you? Yes, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Great. Yes, let us say tomorrow your father accepts to buy you a vehicle, which is a Himalayan vehicle. You know that Himalayan, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Royal Enfield Himalayan. So, when you buy that vehicle, you know that you have to pay a lot of taxes. You have to pay the tax for the vehicle, you have to pay the insurance, you have to pay the tax. So many taxes are there. So there are so many third parties. Actually, there is only two entities. There is Yash, and Yash is buying some vehicle from some X company, but there are 100 people involved who will be getting the taxes. Are you getting this point, Rahul?
Yes, now, sir.
Now, why this Bitcoin came? Because they wanted to remove this third party. Why the third party should become rich? Okay, I'll tell you my example also. This is a bad example, but this can be taken as a motivation for doing good things. I was very naive like you, Rahul, or Dhruv, very, very young, 21, 22 years. And I started my job very early. I got married very early. And somebody pushed me to buy a house very early when I was just 24. So I bought that house on a housing loan in a bank. So when I paid all the loan, I knew that whatever, suppose the cost of the loan was, house was 1 rupee, I had to pay 3 rupees. So 3 times I had to pay the money. So who became rich here? The bank became rich here. So there was a system wherein there was a belief in many people that this system making third party rich is not good. So let us try to wriggle out of that. So that's where the initial motivation of coming out with Bitcoin or a blockchain was there. Rahul, did I make my point clear?
Yes, sir.
Great. Thank you. Any other person has a question? Pratham, Archit, are you there?
Sir, as you gave your second example as of housing loan, how would Bitcoin help in this case?
Okay, you have become more technical now. So one example can be that Bitcoin interest rate may be very, very, very low. So instead of 3 rupees, which I paid, that can be, I paid only 1.20 rupees. Are you getting it? My house cost is 1 rupee, but the traditional way is I had to pay 3 rupees, 3 times I had to pay. But Bitcoin, the very reason of Bitcoin, not Bitcoin, blockchain or this blockchain technology, cryptocurrency. Bitcoin, I should not use the word. I should use the word cryptocurrency and blockchain. So blockchain technology and cryptocurrency, maybe they come out with a system wherein I have to pay only 1 rupees 20 paisa only. So am I safe here? Which option was good for me?
Sir,
paying 3 rupees or paying 1 rupees 20 paisa?
1 rupees 20 paisa.
That's great. So hopefully I answered your question. So same applies everywhere. Now it is your daily life where you book a flight, you book a hotel, you travel, you go to a destination place, stay there. So everywhere slowly you will see that Bitcoin is coming into picture. Sorry, again, I'm using the word Bitcoin. Blockchain is coming into picture. And therein you'll be making a lot of savings and you'll be getting a lot of security also. It has also other perks like you may get some coupons and so on. So it's a transition. It will not happen in a day. It will not happen in a day. Okay. So maybe another 10 years, you'll be seeing everywhere the implementation is through blockchain technology. Is it not? Even you are go to an airport and your transition is happening. So there also you'll be seeing blockchain technology being used. Show your ID and kind of things. Your ID is everything will be replaced in future. Okay, so let us try to move further. So let us use the first line regarding what is this blockchain. It is a digital ledger of transaction. It is a digital ledger of transaction. Now, tell me, what is the meaning of a ledger?
It's used to keep track of different things, mainly transactions.
Okay. Yeah. Great. So I'm highlighting this word digital ledger. So what is blockchain? Is blockchain is actually a digital ledger of transactions. So I'll only speak about this word ledger. Ledger is what, if you go to bank, you see many big files. Those files are called as ledger files, wherein everything is recorded. Somebody is deposited the money, somebody has withdrawn the money. So all that transactions are written on that notebook. That notebook is a ledger. Nowadays it's online system banking. Online banking has come, computers have taken over, but that is what is a ledger. But what is a blockchain? Blockchain is a digital ledger. You don't have that notebook
but you have a notebook which is digital notebook. So that's a digital ledger. This digital ledger is of what transaction. Somebody buys something, so that transaction will be there. That transaction will be there on that digital ledger. So blockchain uses peer-to-peer network. Peer-to-peer network, our machines are connected to each other with equal rights. Distributed environment. So this ledger, which is a digital ledger, you cannot make changes in that. This digital ledger, you cannot make changes in that. This digital ledger is very secure and trust-based. This digital ledger is very secure and trust-based. Now, why it is secure and trust-based? Which algorithm it is using? Tell me, do you remember? Do you remember, Rahul, which algorithm I told? Yash or Dhruv, which algorithm I told? What's the name of the algorithm?
The secure hash algorithm.
Excellent, excellent. That is SHA, as it is mentioned here. And it may be SHA 256. So SHA algorithm, SHA 256 algorithm is a secure hashing algorithm which makes this blockchain or this digital ledger, this distributed ledger, secure and trust-based. Okay. So what is very interesting is I just used the word hack and I gave various examples, like Dhruv's machine is hacked by his friend because he's angry with him. Somebody is a patriotic boy from India who has hacked the portals or websites of Pakistan because he's angry with Pakistan. But when you speak about blockchains, when you speak about blockchains, they are unhackable till now. They are unhackable till now. So this is what is your blockchain. This is what is your blockchain basically, okay? So I request you to spend few seconds and have a look at this image and let us try to decipher this. Let us try to understand this. Okay. Anybody wants to highlight? Archita, you want to highlight this image? Tell me something about this. Archita, am I audible to you? Hari, will you tell me? Yeah. So as you can see, this is a banking system, the left one side. You have a centralized ledger system. There is a clearing house. There is a third party involved. And as you can see here, there is a distributed ledger wherein blockchain is used and there is no third party involved. So this is the distinction between the centralized ledger and the distributed ledger. Okay. Now, the word blockchain, what it indicates? There are two words in this blockchain word, block and chain. So what is a block? Block is a bundle of records. And what is a record? It can be an example of any transaction. Suppose you buy something, that's a transaction, right? So you have many records. Those many records brought together will be block. And those block, many blocks linked together will be blockchain. That's what is blockchain. And that's what is your blockchain. So what I'll do is, now I'll give you a small task, okay? That task is like this. First of all, just confirm Rahul, Hari, Dhruv, Archita, Yash, Pratham, am I audible to you?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, great. Yes, sir. So, what I want you to do is, I want you to Google this, whatever I highlighted. Somebody read for me. Archita, you read for me whatever I highlighted. I think Archita is out of range. Somebody will help me. Hari, will you read it?
Bitcoin peer-to-peer electronic cash system.
Dhruv, you want to take up? Excellent. So Bitcoin, a peer-to-peer electronic cash system. So this is a paper. This is a paper. And as you can see, the author name is Satoshi Nakamoto. And what we have said about Satoshi Nakamoto? He may be a person, but he may be a fictitious person. There may be multiple people involved who have created this fictitious entity, right? So what I want you to do is a small task. All of you, Google for this paper, download this paper, just walk through of this paper and talk to me one line about that. That's the only thing. I'll be giving you 4 or 5 minutes for that. Is it fine? This small task will you do? Rahul, will you do? Dhruv, will you do?
Okay.
I'll copy paste this in the chat window. Yeah, I'll copy paste this in the chat window. What you have to do? You have to Google this, download the PDF, read it. Not entirely, just make a walkthrough of that. And we'll be coming back again. This is 10:50. At 10:55 again, we'll be starting talking. Till that, I'm giving you the time for this task, right? Okay, just confirm. Please confirm. Dhruv, will you do it? Pratham, will you do it? Pratham, will you do it?
Yes, sir.
Yash, will you do it?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Hari and Rahul, you'll do it. Great. Thank you. So after 5 minutes, we'll be again discussing.
Okay, guys, so are you ready? I'll just mention the name and he has to speak at least one line about this paper. I'll start with who left. Somebody left? Okay, no issues. Should I start with who is my favorite? Okay, I'll start with Dhruv. Dhruv, would you like to speak a line about this paper?
Yes, sir. So I just glanced through it. And overall, I'm seeing what you said. There's been this emphasis on removing the middleman and the third party and making it a little bit more secure and transparent for the people, the users.
Fantastic, Dhruv. Fantastic. Now I request Rahul to just speak about this paper.
Basically, what I understood by reading it, by going through it, is it contains both the pros and cons regarding the use of blockchain systems. Well, at first, actually, sir, after reading this, I have a doubt, sir.
Yeah, you can not ask. You can ask the doubt, but not now. You have to tell now. You have to speak.
Okay. I have to speak about it first. Well, regarding the third party payment, how this would affect one's own financial benefits more than others.
Great, Rahul. Fantastic. Thank you, Dhruv and Rahul. Now I request Hari to just speak about the paper.
So a Bitcoin is a ledger. It has the history of all the transactions which are done. So people verify your transactions, and for each transaction verified, the person, the miners who verify the transaction are rewarded in Bitcoin.
Okay. Good. Who will be the next? I think Yash, will you do it?
Sir, this involves a system where it aims at creating like a system where there is no middleman and it wants to make a free transaction phase between the buyer and the one who's and the one receiving it. And the middlemen are not the ones who will be making like what you spend.
I understood what you are trying to convey. Fantastic. Very well presented, very well told. Archita, now you are in our zone. Are you audible? Am I audible to you? Can you speak, Archita? Archita Jain? I'll just verify once again. Archita, are you there? Are you having some connection issues, network issues? Okay. Fair enough. No issues. So let us try to decipher this paper. I'll not read the entire paper. We'll just walk through the paper and we'll highlight a few of the keywords mentioned there. So as you can see, Bitcoin is a peer-to-peer electronic cash system. So here two words are there. One is electronic cash system. You know it. What is a cash? But this cash should be electronic cash. So no paper cash, no plastic cash, no paper cash. So there is a peer-to-peer world. So the way computers are connected, the mechanism is peer-to-peer. And there is a name of the author. There is a name of the author called as Satoshi Nakamoto. So we have already told that this man may be there, this man may not be there, this may be a fictitious entity, this may be a physical entity, and so on. And this is the website www.bitcoin.org. Let us try to check whether this website works or not. Yeah, it is there. So what, see the keywords here. Get started with Bitcoin, choose your wallet, buy Bitcoin. So, and what is Bitcoin? He has mentioned. So resources. So participate, you can buy bitcoins, run a fooling node. Okay, I have a question now while walking through this. I'll put a word in the chat window. No issues, Archita, I got your message that you have some network issue, no problem. But hopefully you are listening to me. Anyways, I have a question. And that question is, there is a very, very famous term called as mining. There is a famous term called as mining in the blockchain industry, in the blockchain domain. So that mining word related to blockchain is very famous. So by any chance, any of you know it, or I may request you to Google for it, mining in blockchain, and you have to tell me about it. Okay, speak, that's it. Because I have been speaking since
the process
more than 26 years.
Process of creating it, sir. Yeah. Making okay. Bitcoin is Great. Called Bitcoin mining.
Okay. I'll keep aside this discussion a little bit. I want others to respond.
The miners verify the transactions, and this is known as Bitcoin mining. So if they are the first one to verify the transaction and their transaction is correct, then they are rewarded in Bitcoin or whatever the network they are using.
Okay, good. Somebody else wants to respond? Okay, then I'll talk about it. So I was saying mining is a very famous word. As far as this blockchain domain is concerned. I have a common question. What is a miner in general terms? Who does mining? There is a coal mining, there is a gold mining, there is a silver mining, there is a metal mining, is it not? There are people, right? There are expert people who go and do mining, workers who do the mining, is it not? So what the workers are given? The workers are given some payment, some salary. So for 8 hours you do the mining, these many dollars you'll be paid, these many rupees you'll be paid. So similarly, in blockchain world, miners who do mining are experts in blockchain technology. Or users like Rahul and Yash and Hari and Archita and Dhruv. So users like them. So they are the miners, and who will be doing some technical work related to that. So they'll be paid also. What will be the payment? The payment will be in again some coins or currency and some coupons and whatever. So, but what they are exactly doing, they're doing some technical stuff related to mining means what? So basically what they're doing is they'll be, if there is a new block to be added in the blockchain, so they'll be helping in that. They'll be helping in the security of that. They'll be helping in how it cannot be hacked and all that aspect. So that's a very famous term, and you can explore it whenever you get time. So we'll be moving further now.
So my doubt.
Yeah, now we can talk about your doubt.
After reading that, I understood that the Bitcoin is for the betterment of an individual, but how would it help the society in the development of society? Because the tax we pay are actually, most of it is used in the betterment of the country itself.
Yeah, very correct, Rahul. Taxes are the things through which the governments run, or the policies like doing good roads and infrastructure, all that happens. But if everything is more secure, everything is more transparent, everything is more trustworthy, the taxes are reasonable and nobody is getting affected with that, why not? So this is a disruptive technology. The way your things were happening, even the taxes you are paying. So it may pave a new way wherein the individual will not feel that I am taxed more and I am not given returns. I am not given good infrastructure, I am not given good road, I am not given good hospitals. Or a businessman may not feel that, okay, my taxes are reasonable. Whatever I am paying, I am getting the returns for that also. So that this is the journey of that. This is the journey for that. Hopefully, I could answer your question, Rahul. Okay.
Yes, so,
okay. So we were speaking about, we'll make a walkthrough of this paper. We were speaking about, we'll make a walkthrough of this paper. And this walkthrough of this paper means we'll not read the entire paper, but I'll just pick up some word and I'll just try to connect the dots. So this is a paper, Bitcoin, peer-to-peer, electronic cash system, okay? Online payments. You're not going through any financial institution. You're not going through any financial institution means what? See, you're using this mechanism. You are using distributed mechanism. You are not using ledger, centralized ledger mechanism, where there is a financial institution, clearing house, bank, third parties involved, which may also charge you, Okay, so they started with digital signatures for this online electronic cash system. But they wanted to remove the third party because with the third party, you're spending more. With the third party, you are spending more. So this spending more problem is called as double spending. This spending more problem is called as double spending. So with this Bitcoin or blockchain technology, this double spending and the third party spending, this double spending or the third party spending is overcome. Okay. Now, there is a network of machines. What is internet? The world, all over the world is connected now. Every device is connected, whether it is CCTV cameras or your cameras or your mobiles or our laptops or your Kindles. Everything is connected and everything can be tracked. So all those resources become part of the network. Okay. And when you timestamp your transactions, okay, using hashing mechanism in a chain, okay, in a chain that forms a record which cannot be changed. So that was the proof of work for this initial paper. So they created a chain. That chain is called as what? Blockchain. They created a chain. That chain is called as what? Blockchain. This is our blockchain, right? Records, collection of records makes block. Collection of blocks or blocks linked together. Blocks linked together become a chain and that becomes your blockchain. That becomes your blockchain. What we are doing right now, we are just making a walkthrough of this paper. So broadcasting messages is used. Nodes, if they leave, no problem, they can rejoin back and so on. So here you have the word cryptography, you have electronic payment. What is the proposal? Solution to double spending, removing the third party, using what? Peer-to-peer distributed timestamp. Okay. This distributed timestamp is what? Computational proof of chronological order of the transaction. This system is secure and so on. This is your diagram. Okay, spend a few seconds on this diagram also. We are not going to understand this diagram in its entirety, but we know that there are transactions, there are multiple owners, owner number one, owner number two, owner number three. They are using cryptography, they are using encryption, so that's why they are using public keys and private keys, as well as they are using hashing algorithms, for these kind of transactions, So you have a timestamp server. With the help of the timestamp, only those become the identify the proof for the chronological order. So as you can see, every block is connected to another block. So try to let us again understand this with the help of this. See here, this is a blockchain. Okay, this is a blockchain. And blockchain is what? Chain of blocks. So block number one, block number two, block number three, block number n.
So this chain of blocks are linked together, And what is a block? A block contains records. What is a block? A block contains records. And what is a record? So record may be a transaction like this. Instead of Sam, let us call this Dhruv. Instead of Peter, let us call this Rahul. So from Dhruv to Rahul, there was a payment of 200 valued Bitcoin. There was a payment of 200. So this is a transaction. This is a transaction. Okay. So this is a blockchain. This is a blockchain. So you have blocks. You have blocks and there is a chain of these blocks. They are linked together. You have blocks. There is a chain of blocks and all these are linked together. Okay. So let us go back to the paper again. So now this is block number one. Let us say this is block number two and they're interconnected here. From here also blocks are coming. From here also blocks are coming. So there is something called as a previous hash and there is something called as a nonce. There is something called as a previous hash. There is something called as a nonce. Again, I have a special request. This nonce is a very, very special word in the blockchain domain. So I request you to Google the word nonce, N-O-N-C-E. I put it in the chat window. I put in the chat window and you have to tell me, what is the meaning of that nonce? Somebody will be help me out.
Number only once used.
Okay, but what is the purpose? Just check it out. What is the purpose of that?
A nonce is an abbreviation for number only used once, which is a number added to a hashed or encrypted block in a blockchain that when rehashed meets the difficulty level restrictions. The nonce is the number blockchain miners are solving for in order to receive cryptocurrency.
Fantastic. I want this last line very important. Have you read the word miners?
Yes, sir.
Great. And what the miners are doing, it is mentioned here. See here. What the miners are doing?
Solving.
Okay. So what they are solving, the nonce, how to evolve, come out with the nonce number, which is a only once used number, which is a unique number kind of, identity number kind of thing. And these miners will try to, it is like a contest. It is like a mining contest where miners will be told to identify the nonce, If they do that, what they will get? They'll get some prize. What is that prize? In the form of a cryptocurrency. Fantastic, fantastic. Very well put. Let us go ahead now. See here, we are not reading the entire paper. We are just highlighting few things. Whenever new transaction happens, it will be broadcast to all the nodes. Every node will be collecting all the transactions in a block. So every node will make it very difficult, maybe through nonce, maybe through all the numbers. They'll be broadcasting the block to the nodes. A node will be accepting a block if the transactions are valid. Node once accepts, it will be sending an acceptance message. Okay, so this is again, we have read through. This I don't want in today's discussion. Okay, there is a word called as Merkle root. Again, this is a technology which uses some data structure to make more secure of this hashing or make it more reliable kind of thing. So you can take this as a assignment word, Merkle root. I'll put it in the chat window and you, not now, but later on, you can read related to blockchain technology. What this Merkle root may be playing the role in this entire thing. Okay, this is the traditional model wherein we have a third party like a bank. Okay, but here in the new model, there is no third party. There is no third party, trusted third party. Okay, these are the calculations. These are very, very important. Then the C code is there. So this all can be your kind of work. And
you can again visit GitHub. So I have a question to all of you. Whatever I am going to type in the chat window, two words I am going to type in the chat. Do you know these two words? Without seeing, without Googling. If you know it, somebody read for me. Not Rahul, not Dhruv. Yash or Hari, you read these two words which I put in the last.
GitHub and Kaggle.
Excellent. Hari, do you know GitHub or Kaggle?
GitHub is a repository for code and Kaggle is a place where you can get all the databases.
Now, I have a question to all of you. Everybody will be answering me in yes or no. Okay. Have you registered with GitHub and Kaggle? Have you registered with GitHub and Kaggle? Anybody has IDs for GitHub and Kaggle? Hari, Rahul,
yes,
Yash,
I have.
Hari has it. Rahul, do you have it?
No, sir.
Yash, do you have it?
No, sir.
Dhruv, do you have it?
No, sir.
Archita, do you have it? Okay, she has a network issue, but I am anticipating. Maybe she has, maybe she doesn't. That. Now I request you to spend 5 minutes on registering with GitHub and Kaggle. Both the words I put in the chat window, I'll again copy paste them in the chat window. What you have to do, you have to Google first for GitHub and you have to register with it. And you have to Google next Kaggle and you have to register with it. Believe me, whatever profession you take up, whatever profession you take up, you'll be using it for many projects, many activities, very, very interesting, those who don't know it. So I have a special request, treat it as a task, take 5 minutes, it is 11:20 now. So everybody will be registering with GitHub and Kaggle. And once after 5 minutes, everybody will be sharing his screen and showing me that he has registered. Will you do it, all of you? Hey, respond. Yash, Dhruv.
Will okay,
you do sir. It? I'm doing it right now.
Great, 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 great. So it is 11:20 at 11:25. So I'll also have a tea break, 5 minutes. Meanwhile, you can finish off these two activities.
Forget me, forget me. I'm feeling bad. Buying all my your arms and mine. Yes, my ex. Come get me. I don't want sex to the bed. Come get me. So you're still thinking of me, just like I know you should. I cannot give you everything, you know I wish I could. I'm so high at the moment, I'm so caught up in this. Yeah, we're just young, dumb, and broke, but we still got love to give. While we're young, dumb, young, young, dumb, and broke. Young, dumb, young, young, dumb, and broke. Young, dumb. Young, young, dumb, and broke. Young, dumb, broke high school kid.
Yeah, I think you might have finished. I request those who have finished, they can just for a minute show me on the screen. I'll stop presenting. You can share your screen. Anybody is ready? Yes, you want to go first?
Yes, sir, I completed, but how do I do this now, sir?
Okay. Yes, you go first then.
Okay, present now, sir.
Yes, you are not audible. Can you speak a bit loudly?
Yes, sir, I'll present now.
You're finished?
Yes, sir, finished.
Okay, then you show it. Present, share the screen. Good, good.
So this is for GitHub.
Great, great, great. Whatever you are seeing, you can just explore and tell 2-3 words and we can move for the next student. Okay, this was GitHub,
sir,
right?
I didn't see, sir. I just logged in.
Okay, 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 yes, okay. No. Then can you show Kaggle if you have done it, Yash?
Yes, sir, I'll show. This is Kaggle, sir.
Fantastic. Well done, Yash. Well done, well done. You can explore leisurely. And
yes, sir.
If we get opportunity, we can further discuss what kind of projects, what kind of contest we can participate in. After Yash, who is ready? Rahul, are you ready? Or Hari, are you ready? Yeah, you're doing it on mobile, I think. Yeah, great. No issues. Very good, Rahul. Very good. So, you're done, Rahul? Rahul, will you show Kaggle also, if possible? I think, am I audible first?
My screen has freeze, sir.
Okay. No. Then we'll go for next. Hari, are you there?
Yeah, I'm just showing.
Okay.
This is Gabriel.
Great, 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 Hari. GitHub, you're doing it or done?
I'm just sharing the screen.
Okay. Right. Well done. Who is remaining? I think Dhruv is remaining. Dhruv, you there?
I'm still doing it, sir.
Okay. Can you share the screen and show, if possible, if you're comfortable?
Yes, sir. One second. So do I select all these things?
Yeah. Acha, you're still doing it. No problem.
Yeah, I'm still doing it.
No issues. But everybody has tried or done it. No issues. You can stop presenting, Dhruv. But only request is finish registering for both Kaggle and GitHub.
Yeah, I will. Yeah.
So we'll try to move further. We were just making a walkthrough of this paper, and I have a special request again. Try to implement this in by extracting the Bitcoin related tasks from GitHub and Kaggle. Go to GitHub and Kaggle, extract activities or tasks related to Bitcoin, and try to understand them, try to play around with them, and so on. So as well, as you all have downloaded this paper, better you save it at a place and at leisure read it, because this is a technology which is worth watching for. So let us go back to our PowerPoint presentation, but let me confirm whether I have started presenting or not. Yeah, I forgot to share the screen. Now I am sharing the screen. Now, we were speaking about blockchain, where we have blocks. Blocks are records like this, and all the blocks form a chain which are interconnected with each other. So as you can see here, now you have to pay very carefully attention to this slide. Every block has a hash. Hash is what here it is mentioned. It is like a unique ID. Hash is like a unique ID. This is your hash. For example, for this block 2, this is the hash. You can say this is a secure secret identity, secure secret identity kind of thing. So every block will have a hash. Every block will have a hash. And you also see that there is a previous hash also. There is a previous hash also. For example, block number two has this hash. Okay. So, but block number 3 has the record of previous hash of block number 2 here, the record of previous hash. Okay, that is for ensuring against safety, security. So for example, if there is a difference in the hash number, you know that something is wrong in this chain. So whatever was there related to these blocks and blockchain and how, what is nonce and what is this hash and previous hash, we'll just watch a small video. Where is that video? Yeah.
This is a blockchain demo.
Observe very carefully.
This in a very visual way, though. I'm going to make it very easy to understand.
Even if it is not audible, that's fine.
The key pieces of what a blockchain is in a visual way. But before we get started, we need to take a look at this thing that we call a SHA-256 hash, okay? And the hash, this is one of them right here. Hash looks like a bunch of random numbers. And essentially what it is, it's a fingerprint of some digital data. And it just so happens, it's a fingerprint of whatever I type in this box. So if I type my name, Anders, into this box, you see that the hash has changed. As a matter of fact, it changed every time I typed a letter, right? So I'm going to go back to, so it says Anders. Okay, so this is the hash of the name Anders, all lowercase. It starts with 19EA, right? Okay, so if I delete that and I go again, type Anders again, you can see it starts with 19EA, the same exact hash. In that sense, it's a digital fingerprint of this data. Whatever data is here Every time you type exactly the same data, you get exactly the same hash. And I can type anything I want. So I can even have nothing, like this, you know, E3B0, that's the hash of nothing. Or you could type tons and tons of stuff. As a matter of fact, you could put like the Library of Congress in here and you would get a hash. And the interesting thing about it is, regardless of there, if there's a tiny amount of information, no information, or the entire Library of Congress, you're always going to get a hash that is this long, this many characters. So you're not going to be able to pre-guess what this is. You kind of have to put the Library of Congress in here to figure out what the hash is. But you'll always get exactly the same hash regardless of how many times you put exactly the same information in. So what I'm going to do is extend this idea of a hash into something that we're going to call a block. All right, so let's take a look at a block. So this is a block, and it's exactly like the hash. It's just that that data section I've broken out now into three sections. One called block, this is just some kind of a number, this is block number one. A nonce, which is just yet another number, we'll go into what that is in a second. And then just some more data, just very similarly to the way that we had it before. However, the hash of this, which includes all of this information up here, is down here, and it begins with four zeros. You see that? That's a relatively unusual hash. You know, most of them are not really going to start with four zeros like that, but this one happens to. And because it does, totally arbitrarily, I'm going to say that this block is signed. Okay? So what would happen if I were to change any one piece of this information? Let's say if I were to type something here, right? The hash is going to change. And what's the chance of that if I type letters, this hash is going to start with four zeros? Pretty low. It's probably not, right? So let's see what happens when I do that. I'm just going to say hi. Oh, look at that, right? This hash does not start with four zeros. And so the big background here is turned red. So now you know that this block with this information in it is not a valid or a signed.
We'll run it for another 1 minute, max.
This nonce is just a number that you can set to try to find a number that fits so that this hash starts with four zeros again. Right, so how do we do that? Well, let's start with one. Does that start with now? It's 3, 2, 7. That's not one. So let's try two. FF, no. 3, 4. 5, 6, you get the idea. Like I could sit here, there's one that starts with 0. I could sit here all day typing these numbers and trying to figure out one that actually is going to hash out to something that starts with 4 zeros. Gonna take a long time. So here I have my little mind button. I'm sure you've been wondering what happens if I press that. So what's gonna happen when I press this mind button is it's gonna run through all of the numbers from 1 all the way up to try to find one where the hash starts with four zeros. And this process is called mining. Let's do it right now. Now it's checking all of the numbers from 1 all the way up there. Now it's stopped at 59,396. And that one just happens to hash out to something that starts with four zeros. And it satisfies my little definition of what a signed block is. Okay, so that's a block. Now, can you tell me what a blockchain is? It's probably just a chain of these blocks. Well, how do you put them together? Let's do that. All right, so here's my blockchain. I have block number one. It has some kind of a nonce just like before. There's some data area to it. But then it has this previous. You know, it's a bunch of zeros. Let's roll forward. So this is block two and block three and four. This blockchain has 5 blocks on it, right? The previous here starts with 00AE8, right? Is this number, AE8. And then this previous, you know, B90 is this one over here, B90. So you can see that each block points backwards to the one before it. You remember that the first block over here, there actually is no previous, so it's just a bunch of zeros. It's actually just a fake number. Okay. So, just like we did before, what happens if I change some information here? right? It's going to change the hash of this block and it's going to invalidate it, right? Well, let's try that. So I'm going to hi again. Sure enough, that block is invalid. All right, just as we assumed. But what would happen? I'm going to fix that now. We'll go back to something that worked. What would happen if I change something in this block?
I think we got a pretty good idea, but let me confirm, are you all there or not? Okay. Now Dhruv, Rahul and Yash, three people are there. So hopefully this video helped us in understanding what a blockchain is, what a nonce is, what a block is, what a miner does, what is mining, and so on. What is the purpose of that previous hash and current hash? So this is basically your blockchain. As you can see, this diagram, block number 1, 2, 3, 4. So like that, these are from different blocks, different persons. This is a distributed peer-to-peer network. There is a consensus among all the persons, and this is the linkages of all the blocks. So for example, they are agreeing on this transaction. All these four persons are agreeing on this transaction, which is there at the block number 4. What are the applications of blockchain? These are the various applications. You can use it as Bitcoin, you can use it in music, banking, payments, transfer, healthcare, real estate, digital IDs, Internet of Things, law enforcement, everywhere. So because your daily routine activities, whatever you're doing with the help of technology, slowly you'll see that gradually blockchain technology will take over all those activities, be it travel, be it mobiles, be it hotels, be it aeroplane, transit, anything. This is a use case in telecom. So telecom industry means telephones, mobiles, and so on. Okay. So basically, if I'm using blockchain in telecom, I'm removing a third party. Okay. I'll be cutting the cost, improving the efficiency. Spam calls and messages from marketers, as it is more secure and more trustworthy, can be overcome. You have a distributed ledger technology. Real-time transparency, for example, KPI tracking. Then you have a list of blocks and secure hashing algorithm and so on. So this is one use case in telecom. So I'll mention one use case in other areas. For example, here, digital currency use case is mentioned. I'll just click on this and hopefully this will open. This is a newspaper news, actually, Economic Times, where you see Wipro is a company. And R3 is a company. They collaborated together. Wipro is again ahead in most of the companies as far as blockchain implementation is concerned. As you can see here, Wipro and R3 together are implementing this blockchain-based solution for digital currency in a country called as Thailand. So this is the news, and it means it's happening. So currency in Thailand is using or slowly will be taking over, entire thing will be taken over by blockchain. So initially there may be prototype, there may be implementation hiccups and so on, but it will slowly happen. The next use case is driving licenses, IDs, proof of age. I'll use this link also for that. Okay, so it is unable to download, but you can see here in South Korea, driving licenses, proof of age, IDs, all of them are using this blockchain implementation. All of them are using this blockchain. You see use case of a blockchain in travel industry also, for example, secure payments, third party elimination, ID and security, loyalty programs like coupons I mentioned, baggage tracking. So this will be resolving the logistic challenges. Companies which adopted blockchain are like TUI, Lockchain, TripKey. So they have also a loyalty reward system. They also have a loyalty reward system. So similarly, you have blockchain in sports also. For example, smart investment contracts, ticket sales, eliminating the middleman, counterfeit ticket sale will be stopping, regulation, transparency, and drug testing. And this is the use case in sports. So as you can see, all the areas of life, routine activities, they can be slowly taken over by blockchain and you can reap the benefits of that, hopefully. So I'll, for a minute, 1 minute each, I'll play these videos and then we can go for further. So let me check. So this is blockchain in telecom.
Everyone, and welcome to class of blockchain in telecom. Telecom industry today has the most complex operations framework. It involves many partners, vendors, customers, distributors, network providers, and value-added services providers. There are the involvement of. So blockchain helps in this. Like it will help in internal processes. Processes such as OSFP blockchain.
I'm just making a fast walkthrough of this.
Solve the faults across, because here it is going to This will also help with automatic generation of billing amounts and payments.
So let us look for blockchain in travel.
We're surrounded by digital transactions, millions and billions of them. These transactions form the foundation of our society, and they're at the point of being revolutionized by a technology called blockchain. Blockchain is a decentralized encrypted database shared across a network of stakeholders where digital transactions can be stored and organized in a transparent, verifiable, and secure way. Information added to the blockchain has to be validated by consensus, accepted by all parties, rather than by one central administrator. This reduces errors, as there is no single point of control. Each block of information added to the chain is timestamped. This ensures that the information is auditable and traceable at any time. Most importantly, blocks added to the blockchain can never be removed or modified, eliminating the risk of data tampering and fraud. Blockchain is a young technology, but it has the potential to disrupt the way business is traditionally done. At Amadeus, we're already investigating the impact it can have on the world of travel. For example, payments, making settlements between different parties, like hotels, travel agents, and aggregators, can be an extremely complex process, especially across borders. Blockchain could streamline this process by reducing the intermediaries and the settlement timing while increasing the overall flow transparency. Traveler ID verification. Today, travelers are required to show their ID at multiple stages of the journey, from booking to boarding to checking in at the hotel. Blockchain could make this more secure while simplifying traveler identification at every stage. Baggage tracking. Another challenge is keeping track of travelers' luggage, as it changes hands from airlines to ground handlers at airports. Blockchain will allow all parties to exchange information, even if they are not in the same alliance or related to the same segment, improving the accuracy of baggage tracking across the industry. At Amadeus, we believe we are only just starting to see the possible applications of blockchain in the world of travel. The challenge will be to continue to find where blockchain can add value. At Amadeus, we are...
So we'll see for 1 minute this last video and then we'll move further.
Hi, yeah, this is Mr. Zuckerberg. The hardest part of my job...
Tom loves traveling. When it comes to booking, he likes to use online travel agencies to save time and stay under budget. But Tom doesn't know that. One, in every $100 he spends, $20 to $30 go to the online booking agencies. Two, overbooking, inaccurate room descriptions, and false reviews happen frequently on these online booking platforms. What you experience is often very different from what is described on these websites. Three, when you have a dispute, these online platforms are often absent or slow to react. Even after they take a big chunk of your money, they are not eager to fix the problem for you. Is there a better way to book your accommodations? Meet Tripio, the future of travel booking, built on blockchain. Tripio's goal is to help the online travel industry improve by leveraging the decentralized, tamper-resistant, and traceable features of the blockchain technologies. Tripio builds a verifiable trust network among strangers. All transactions will be supported and protected by smart contracts. These smart contracts connect service providers and customers directly without any middleman. There is no need for centralized systems to ensure the process of payments, reviews, and arbitrations. Smart contracts will be automatically executed according to agreed rules and terms. On Tripio, 1. You have access to accurate and reliable room descriptions and customer reviews. 2. You can pay your host directly with digital currency, saving the middleman markup and conversion cost.
So, that those are a few of the use cases, and even in sports we had mentioned that. So if you have any questions, please ask. Okay. Now I'd like to come back on video. I also request Dhruv, Rahul, and Hari to come back on video for a minute. Then we'll close. Then we'll close session. Thank you, Dhruv. Thank you, Rahul. And thank you, Hari, and Yash, and everybody, because you made it more interactive. My only suggestion to you is keep your enthusiasm just as you're enthusiastic now. Explore more technologies, do more projects. Use GitHub and Kaggle and community projects, NGO projects. So that will take you further. And while doing this journey of through Hetik, of whether it is technology, whether it is digital, whether it is digital business, lot of commerce, lot of economy you'll be learning, lot of mathematics you'll be learning. But along with that, keep in mind, being a senior with gray hair, I can tell that ethics plays the major role. Character plays the major role. Empathy plays the major role. So ethics, character, empathy, this is what I learned after 50 years of learning. So I'm just in two lines, I'm telling you that. So while carrying forward your journey of learning, make it possible. Thank you. I just want you to say one line, all of you, all three of you, and then we can close. Surekha Madam will be closing after what they say. Yeah, Dhruv. You can say anything about the course, about today's content, or what you're planning to do, where are you from, anything you do, Dhruv.
It was good, sir. I like this topic, and I think you explained it quite well as well.
Great. And where are you located, Dhruv?
I'm in Bangalore itself.
Great. So, what about you, Rahul?
So it was great interacting with you and learning the new concepts regarding blockchain.
Okay. What's your background? What's your education? And where are you from, Rahul?
I'm a 12th dropout. I mean, I passed out in 2020. I was preparing for NEET. I'm still preparing for NEET 21. And right now I'm at Mumbai.
Oh, great. Mumbai at what location? I was in New Bombay near Vashi.
I'm Kalyan right now.
Okay. Great knowing you all. I think we'll be stopping the session. And again, in the afternoon, 2 p.m., we'll have a one-hour discussion of technologies. Thank you, all of you. Surekha Madam, are you there?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. You can exit, Rahul and Dhruv.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Surekha Madam, are you there?